Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I wanted to talk to you briefly about my December favorites. I wanted to come with you to you last week and talk to you about this, but I got behind. So here it is. I have some goodies this month that I'm really excited about. Most of you know that I make my own body cream that I put on my body. It's nothing fancy. It's just a mix of a butter and a few oils. Like olive oil, coconut oil, hemp oil, that kind of thing, and some essential oils to give it the fragrance that I'm looking for. But this butter that I'm going to share with you today is a butter that I've never used before, and I am completely and totally in love with it. It is mango butter. I don't know if you can see that. It's mango butter, and I absolutely love this butter. It's by Ozlove Organics Pure and Natural. That's the name of the company. I'll put a link for everything that I will show you in this video down below. But I love this butter because it goes into the skin so nicely. It doesn't leave you oily and, it doesn't get on your clothes or anything like that. And my two favorites now are shea butter and mango butter. And I have to say, I like mango better. So this is what's going in my body oils or body care product until, I decide to try something else to see if I find something better. But mango butter, I just absolutely love it. It goes into the skin very well. So here is my second favorite for this month, and it's oil that I use to make my body oil, my body butter that I just got finished talking about, and that is hemp oil. And this particular one is by Nutiva, and it is a Nutiva hemp oil, super organic, superfood, cold fresh. And let me tell you, this mixed with the mango butter is fabulous. I even put it on my face, put my makeup on, and my makeup didn't move. As a matter of fact, I have a tendency to have dry skin. I don't really have dry skin as long as I am drinking enough water. I don't struggle with that. But this goes right into the skin. Like I put it all over my body. It goes into the skin. And I think there's a healing effect that happens. Using this hemp oil is different than me using coconut oil, olive oil, jojoba oil, which are the oils that I've used in the past. This made the difference. I'm telling you, I know it. I know it's this product. These two together go very well. So my next product I left over there. I'm gonna have to get it in a second. But before that, I'm going to go with a face wash that I've been using. And it's by Alba. I've been using a different Alba products over the years, and I've used this product before. And this is a facial cleanser. It's called Hawaiian Facial Cleanser, and it's a pore purifier, pineapple enzyme. So, like I told you, my skin is on borderline dry. If anything, it's not oily. But years ago, it used to be oily, and I used this product and I liked it then, and I like it now. I use this to help take off my makeup off after I've like wiped off the majority with some coconut oil and a tissue, and I use this to cleanse my skin, and it gets all of the makeup off of my face. So I really like this, and it lasts a long time. I bought this in the middle of November. And it's the middle of January. I use it every day at night. And I still have some in the bottle, like maybe about that much left. So a little goes a long way. Next, I want to share with you the toner that I use. And it's by Alba as well. And I bought these two at the same time. It's called the Hibiscus Facial Toner. And I love it. It works well with the cleanser. And I just use my body butter that I make, and I put that on my face before I go to bed. So that's what I use for those things. And the other thing I want to say about this, the reason I'm doing this favorites videos because I get questions about, well, what natural things can I use for my body? Because I know that I'm trying to heal from fibroids and PCOS or whatever it is. And they know that one of the ways to get the toxins out of your body is to start using more natural products. So that's why I'm sharing this information in the first place. So here is the soap that I used most of all of November and December and part of January, the first week of January. It just ran out. My husband and I share this. This is called Purify Deeply Charcoal Detoxifying and Purifying Shower Gel. And this one has eucalyptus in it and coconut oil in it. And you see, we used every last drop of it. A little goes a long way with this. And this is a 32-ounce bottle of this. We both loved it. I loved it. It actually felt like it was really getting my body clean. And it didn't strip my skin. Like, my skin still felt moisturized when I used this. So this product is more natural than most because the first ingredient is water and there's only like 6 ingredients in here. If you're trying to find something without sodium lauryl sulfates in it, this isn't the thing because it has it in there, but it's a little more natural than some of this other stuff they're carrying on the market. This is better than most. So if you want to try this, feel free to try it. Okay, and last but not least, you see my juice here today. You see that straw? Yeah, that is a glass straw. And if you've been to any of my Foods to Avoid webinars to shrink fibroids, you know I talk about plastic. And for so long, I've been seeing people use the glass straws, and I'm like, I don't know. And I like to drink my drinks out of a straw. Best investment I could have made in straws, you know what I mean? So not only is this better to drink out of, I mean, it's like saving the planet or whatever, if you're into that, with throwing away all that plastic when you use plastic straws. But the thing is if you are juicing or drinking smoothies and stuff like that, and you stick a plastic straw in the drink, what happens is because the enzymes and the nutrients and everything that are in those fresh juices and smoothies attach themselves to the straw, you're leaching. It's leaching the plastic into your drink. So that's why it's not good to drink with plastic straws. Unless you have a straw that's BPA free. And I've had those. So that's what I had been using. But the other thing that I like about this is it comes with a little pipe cleaner brush. And it cleans the inside of the straw. So you don't have to worry about, you know, your juice residue and smoothie residue getting stuck inside the straw and not being able to clean it. Because when the straw gets all grungy and everything, who wants to drink out of that? So that's what I love about this. So I'm in love with glass straws now. They're fabulous. And I thought also they would be delicate and I'd be breaking them easy. And it's not like that. They're a really good option to have for drinking your smoothies. So I believe that is it for the December favorites. I will come to you again in February for January favorites. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you all soon. Take care.